A space mission to deflect an asteroid. It's been the premise for more than one Hollywood movie. But next month, NASA launches its DART mission that aims to do this in real life. Joining us now to talk about that and other NASA stories making headlines is local astronomer, planetary scientist, and space enthusiast Mark Hammergren. Welcome back, Mark, and thanks for joining us.
So, thank you for having me. Yeah,
absolutely. NASA's DART. Now that stands for Double Asteroid Redirection Test. Sounds like a Hollywood movie mission, as we've mentioned. But explain what NASA intends to do here.
So the DART mission will go to asteroid Didymos, which is a double asteroid system, and this most of the spacecraft is going to just smack into one of into the moon of the asteroid. So this asteroid actually has a moon going around it, and it's the spacecraft is going to smack into it and deflect that moon a little bit. And the goal is to figure out, well, what happens to that asteroid system? How much does it get deflected?
Okay. So, you know, is the purpose here just to test that this can be done in the event that we actually need to change the course of an asteroid in the future?
Well, you know, I don't think there's a just about it. This is a very important kind of test to be made. This is the first test of its kind. And if we ever need the capability to deflect an asteroid, then this is going to be an essential kind of test. But on top of that, this kind of energetic impact will give us information about the internal structure of this asteroid and by extension other asteroids. So there's a lot of science that will come out of this as well.
Of course, a very important experiment that's happening. Well, I'm sure scientists will learn a lot. So if this were to have, you know, a small impact on the asteroid's orbits, could that be enough? Should an asteroid need to be redirected?
Yeah, absolutely. The key factor here is the lead time. How much warning time do we have? And how much time do we have to act? Can we knock this asteroid, even just alter its velocity by a fraction of a millimeter a second? Over time, that will build up. And all we have to do is just nudge it enough to miss the Earth. That's really all we have to do. So yeah, absolutely, this is something we can do.
And how far away is this asteroid that we're talking about?
Well, it's a near-Earth asteroid, so it comes within about maybe, it has the potential to come within about 16 times the distance from the Earth to the Moon. So near in astronomical terms is within several million miles. It doesn't pose a direct hazard right now.
Okay, relative term, of course. So sticking with asteroids, NASA is also set to launch its Lucy spacecraft to Jupiter's Trojan asteroids. Explain what makes this mission special.
So this is the first mission going out to the Trojan asteroids. The Trojan asteroids are thousands of asteroids that are, these are small, icy and rocky bodies. In this case, they share Jupiter's orbit. They got stuck in these orbits during the very formation of the solar system 4.5 billion years ago. And they've resided in kind of like this cold refrigerator. So they should have materials that date back around to the beginning of the solar system. Looking at them will give us some insight as to what these conditions were, what they were made of, and also what's the history since that period of time. So it's a look back to these the fossil record of the solar system.
Wow. Okay. And finally, planetary scientists are learning more information about the Jezero crater. Now, that is the one that the Perseverance mission is exploring on Mars. What have we learned about the past history of this crater?
They've got some really cool visuals on these scarps, these buttes, rises of land that were carved out when there was a river delta flowing into the crater. We've thought for a long time that there was a lake in the crater a long time ago in the past. There was a river delta flowing into it. But this cross-sectional view of the terrain that the rover has provided, that you can't get from satellites overhead, is really spectacular because it lets us look at the layers of the rock, the stratigraphy. And that's just like laying out the pages of a book, a history book of the history of Mars. And they've seen boulders up on top that indicate that there were fast flowing flash floods after the period of lake sedimentation.
And quickly before we let you go, Mark, does this show that NASA is in fact in the right place to look for signs of ancient life on Mars?
Yeah, definitely. So it really nails the case that this there was a lake here, there was long period of sedimentation, a great place to look for fossils or organic material, and then flowing water on top of that, rapidly flowing water. It's a great history of Mars right there.
So much to learn on Mars right there. Mark Hammergren, thanks so much for joining us.
My pleasure, always.